stories from Alison Astarita, General Manager of Gentherm Vietnam. Her passions for operations and technology have let her overcome many challenges and barriers. And now Ms. Alison is the only women C-level in Gentherm Global. Now, please give a big hand for Alison. And she's gonna present in Vietnamese. Let's see.
Xin chào.
You see that? You see, yeah.
Tôi là Alison. Tôi đến từ nước Malta, xinh đẹp. Tôi là tham giám đốc công ty Gentherm. Well, so for today, this is as far as my Vietnamese will take me, so hopefully next time will be a bit more. So first of all, I would like to let you know how grateful I am to be here today and be able to share my story and hopefully also break some of the stereotype perceptions. I'm also very grateful to have been born in an era where there is space for women in the workforce. And there is also opportunities for women to develop their careers. And above all, I'm very grateful to my mother. So this is why I placed a photo of me and her many years ago, because she has been instrumental to give me the foundations to be the woman that I am today. So I would like to first start by giving a reflection on what is the situation of women in leadership today. So first of all, the good news is that there is the highest number of women in leadership roles than ever before. When we look at science and technology sector, we see that 18% of leadership roles are occupied by women. So, is this a number that we should be satisfied with? In my opinion, I don't think so. So there is still a lot of work for us to do. And this is why, also from my personal experience, organizations should stop just looking for technical skills. Technical skills can be, in most cases, learned. But it is more attributes like compassion, collaboration, okay, innovation, problem solving. These are the things we should be tapping on. And actually, these are also the skills that actually women happen to excel in. So I'm working for a company called Gentherm. We are an American company, and we are market leaders in providing thermal solutions, mainly for automotive industry. We have 13,000 people across 13 different countries, and 70% of our workforce are women. So in the US, we are also very happy to have been recognized for our commitment in board diversity, okay, by an organization called Women on Boards 2020. So actually, this is an organization that is promoting to have 20% of board members to be women by the year of 2020. So in that position, we are very happy. But when we look at the numbers, in our executive management, also in the management teams within across the countries, well, we see that we still have a lot of work to do. And this is why Gentherm has been embarking on a couple of initiatives to empower women. So for Gentherm, knowledge is the base, okay, is the foundation for empowerment. So this is why we have a global women's network. Okay, so this is a platform where we share the needs of the women in the different countries from where we are operating. It is also a platform where we are sharing knowledge, information, trainings. Okay, and we also, when we look at empowerment, we do not only look inside our factories, but we are also extending our activities within the community. So for example, in our factory in Mexico, okay, some of the staff already provide English classes to young girls in the community where they operate from. In Gentherm, we also groom our future leaders. Okay, so We identify potential leaders from the beginning, and we tailor-make a training program for them, so hopefully they can be the future leaders for Gentherm. And apart from that, Gentherm also provides global opportunities for everyone. And actually, it is this culture that finds me living in Asia now for the past 15 years. So when I started my career, little did I dream of leaving the tiny country in the middle of the Mediterranean, okay, with less than 500,000 inhabitants, to move to China, okay, a country which is 1,000 times bigger. But that is when I was given the opportunity to be part of the startup team for our China factory. In the meantime, I have taken on some other operational roles, and 13 years later, I was given the exciting opportunity to set up a greenfield factory here in Vietnam. So many people ask me, why manufacturing? Why automotive? Also, we saw from Mai's presentation that actually a lot of women do not think that manufacturing is the right industry for women. But well, I have always had a love for the drive, the dynamic environment that there is in a factory. Plus, being in the automotive industry, so this sets a lot of high standards, okay? So this blends very well with my passion for process improvement and for developing people as a whole. I must say, it has not been an easy journey. But I have always believed in my motto, okay? So I'm always open to challenges and always ready to seize new opportunities. I really believe that we are the ones that should take charge of our career. Nobody will look after it for us. So we are the ones that need to know where we want to reach. And what is very important is that we let our leaders know what is our part. Okay, so I must say at least that I have been very lucky, or I'm very thankful to Gentherm management that they have always supported my goals. So it has been an amazing experience so far, setting up Gentherm Vietnam from scratch. Okay, just after 2.5 years of operation, we are now over 700 people, okay, and actually quite a diverse team. So when I look at our management team, the majority are women. And when I look at our office employees, okay, our technical staff, we actually are nearly 50-50. So this did not happen because we've had any targets, any quotas, far from it. We just set from day one, okay, we set a mindset that what we are looking for is attitude, what we are looking for is talent, okay, and that the opportunities are open for everyone. And actually, it is thanks to this mindset that now we can enjoy such a diverse team. So when we started designing our factory, we started thinking, okay, what do we want this factory to be? What do we want Gentherm Vietnam to be? And we came up with two things. So we said that we wanted this to be a place where we develop people as a whole, and we also wanted to be a place where we create a positive working experience. So for us, people are our most important asset. So this is why we invest highly in training, okay? This is where we also give our people the opportunity to lead. So whether it is because they are leading a small project, or they conduct a workshop, or even if it's just an event committee or a canteen committee. So we do have small groups that allow people to practice the leadership skills. We also encourage people to be part of our continuous improvement process. So people can come up and raise, we have channels for people to raise their concerns, to come up with ideas for innovation. So Also, when I say that we want to develop people as a whole, I also mean that we want to develop them professionally and also socially. So this is why from this year we have established what we call a Life Talk series. So we have brought over some external people, okay, external professionals, who can talk to our employees about various subjects. So for example, one of them has been happy parenting, okay? So how can our people make good parents? Also about how can we have good financial planning in our families? Okay, so we really believe that at the end, we see a holistic person. And also we believe that once you are happy in a family, you are also happy at work. Okay. So another thing is that we do spend most of our time at work. So this is why we want to create a place where we have a positive experience, where we go to work not just to have a job. So this is why we give very high priority to the well-being of our people. So first of all, we do provide a good work-life balance. And this is why we could also encourage, you know, this has helped a lot of our working mothers in the company. So they are able to go home relatively on time and be able to look after the family also in the evening. So it is not just a saying, but this is why the management team is very committed to improving the efficiency of our processes, to reducing waste. So like this, when people are doing the job, you know, they can finish the task comfortably on time. Another thing is that we give safety a very high priority. And when we talk about safety, we talk, okay, about safety at work, but we are also talking about safety in life. So as you know, in Vietnam, so most of our employees do commute to work by bike, okay? So this is quite a big concern for us. So together with my team, we have been thinking, okay, we cannot really control what is happening outside, but what can we as a company do to increase the awareness? And so this is why we have given people full face helmets. This is why we have conducted training. So we partnered up, okay, with some motorcycle producers who have come actually on site to give all our employees training, motorbike driving training, okay? And our next topic will be that we will also want to make sure that our people keep the motorbikes in a good condition, okay? So well-maintained. So next topic will be how to do the maintenance, okay? How to look after this condition. Because at the end, this all affects the safety. We also look at ergonomics, okay? So we are a factory, so most of the people, okay, it can be a tedious job, okay? So this is why we try to make sure that our people are comfortable, okay? So whether it's on the shop floor, whether it is in the offices, we focus a lot that our people, while they're at work, they at least can be comfortable. So in general, we also, when we design our factory, we try to break off the traditional silos, okay? We do not function in departments, we are functioning in processes. So different people have to work together. Usually it's whatever we do, we work in a multifunctional team. So we also designed a factory to support this. You will see that we actually do not have any closed offices. Okay, so it's all an open environment and we all work together to support, to reach the common goal. And one other thing is we do regular communication also with our employees, okay? So we like to keep our people all on the same page. And this is why we organize several types of dialogues, so whether it's a town hall, whether it's a social dialogue, or else it's just it's our newsletter. So we really do like to keep, so including our operators, we want to keep everybody on the same page. And above all, we want to make the workplace fun. So this is why we also work on, you know, having quite a lot of activities for our people. So whether it is team buildings, or whether it is any kind of celebration in a factories, or it's our company trip, or it's our family day, but at least we try to put some fun to this. And here, I would like to share with you some of our happy moments at Gentherm. And I would also like to take the opportunity to to thank my team, okay, for helping me in making a difference, for all the contribution and for the support. And actually, some of my team members are here today, and I'm very happy. Thanks for your support. So really, my message to all of you is, you know, just follow your dreams, okay? So nothing actually can stop you, and whatever you want is really comes from within. So wishing you good luck, and hope you can take some takeaways with you. Thank you.